Good evening, basketball fans. Welcome to Vandalia High School and the championship game of the boys class 2A sectional tournament. Tonight, it's the Fairfield Mules with a record of 32-2 against the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes, coming in with a record of 28-5. I'm Randy Olson, courtside, along with Danny Anselment. It's an all-audio broadcast for you tonight, but we do have our live interactive scoreboard on the screen to keep track of the game, and you can see that the time is counting down before the start of this one tonight, as both teams have just come out on the court. And, boy, this is something that we've been waiting on for a long time, Danny. It should be a great matchup tonight between two outstanding basketball programs.
Yeah, you know, Randy, this is going to be... The gym was kind of, the T-Town fans were late arrivals
here
tonight.
They were.
It looked like the Mules was going to have them at least 2-1, maybe 3-1 fan-wise, but they've quickly kind of gathered up.
They've started to catch up now, haven't they?
Jeff Brzezinski told me they still had chores to do. They was just getting in from doing the chores.
Well, there might be some truth to that, too. There might be. These two teams, of course, met way back in November during the Lawrence County Classic up in Lawrenceville. Again, 3 months ago, the Rams won that game. The Mules won that game by 10 points, led by as many as 20. But that was just so long ago, Danny. You can kind of throw that game out, can't you?
Yeah, you know, Randy, that was way back when, and there's been a lot of water under the bridge. These teams have worked and got a lot better, but it'll be a good ball game here tonight. It'll be interesting to see who can instill their will upon each other. This Mules team, I think, may be a little deeper.
Oh, I think they are, too, and I think that could play a big role in tonight's game, particularly if teams get into foul trouble, because let's say, for example, if both teams get in foul trouble and the game comes down to the benches, I definitely give Fairfield the edge on the bench.
But the Mules are going to have to shoot free throws better than they shot the other night.
That's right. They were, what, 3 out of 11?
Yeah,
in their semifinal win?
Had a pretty rough night from the free throw line. So, anyway, it'll be interesting to see what happens.
You talk about the fact that the Mules have a stronger bench. You know, I think they've got better guards, too, than T-Town. Now, that remains to be seen tonight, but certainly that was the clear difference when they played the first time, is the pressure that the Mules applied to the T-Town guards. The Wooden Shoes just weren't able to handle the pressure. And so I like the guard play of Fairfield, and it's tough to find a tandem, you know, that's much better than Wyatt Gilbert and Jazelle O'Neal.
You know, you take Wyatt Gilbert, you know, I always thought he was a pretty good player, Randy, and we saw him down there at the El Dorado Holiday Tournament. And he took the young man from Heron that had scored 22 and 26 points the two games before. He took him completely out of the ball game.
He sure did.
Held him to 2 points. And that really made an impression on me of what kind of defender and what kind of quickness that he had, because that young man from Heron was quick as grease lightning.
Oh, yeah.
And it just showed me really what Wyatt Gilbert really was. And it changed my perspective on him.
He is such a valuable asset out there as a defender, but he can score as well as distribute the ball, too, and he is. He's a valuable asset to this Fairfield Mule Ball Club. But, again, the Mules go very deep, as you said. Coming off the bench, they'll bring three guys in at about the four-minute mark of the first quarter. And the difference, though, is that fact that these four players, or these three players that come in for the Mules off the bench at the four-minute mark, they can come in and make an impact immediately. They come in and score. They just don't come in and take up space, do they?
Oh, no. You know, you take Landon Zerlini come in the other night, Randy, and he led the Mules in scoring. He had 16 points off the bench, and he had 2 3 balls in that first half that were in and out, or he could have had another 6 added on that total off the bench.
Yeah. And the Mules had 4 players in double figures the other night in their blowout win against Payne of 70-33. But the more impressive statistic, I think, is the fact they had 10 players in the scoring column.
Yeah. You know, and it's one of those deals, who are you going to key on?
Right.
Somebody else will pick up the slack. And so anyway, it's the Mules are 32-2 on the season, and there's no reason they're not. But that T-Town team's 28-5. Be interesting to see. They're a little bit bigger than the Mules, so be interesting to see. Brian Estes is not going to be able to get in foul trouble here tonight, or T-Town may be able to pound the ball inside.
And they do like to pound it inside to their 6'7 pivot man, Clint Weber. He and their perimeter player, Dawson Smith, they have been the two guys that have led the Wooden Shoes in scoring all year long. And that was much the same of what we saw in their their semifinal win here against Mount Carmel the other night. So, again, Weber is key to stay on the floor for T-Town as well as Dawson Smith. And if Weber gets in foul trouble, which sometimes he's prone to do, I don't know that T-Town's got another guy that can come off the bench that's going to be as much of a threat offensively as what Weber will be. They got a guy that is 6'7", but I don't think that Charlie Haney is quite the offensive threat that Clint Weber is.
Well, you know, it'll be interesting to see what happens here in about 8 minutes and 30 seconds. We're going to have a jump ball, and we'll get it underway,
yeah.
And we'll know.
We're glad you're with us here live on AreaSports.net. Another one of our sponsors tonight is Frontier Community College. Summer and fall registration begins March 26th at Frontier Community College in Fairfield. You know, Frontier is rated the 15th best two-year trade school in America by Forbes magazine. That's Frontier Community College in Fairfield.
Life may take you. It all starts with the first step. Begin your journey with Frontier Community College, the foundation for your future.
Are you going out of town for a vacation or a weekend getaway? What are you going to do with your dog? That's easy. There's Jagger's Doggy Daycare in Mount Vernon. Jagger's Doggy Daycare is your one-stop shop for overnight dog boarding, doggy daycare, as well as dog grooming and obedience dog training. It's your dog's home away from home, and they will thrive, and they'll get one-on-one attention by a great staff. More information is available on the web at jaggersdoggydaycare.com. Jagger's Doggy Daycare, 414 Main Street in Mount Vernon.
Welcome back to Vandalia High School. Randy Olson and Danny Anselment courtside here for this audio broadcast tonight of the 2A sectional championship game between the Fairfield Mules, 32-2, and the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes at 28-5. We have a live interactive scoreboard on the screen that you'll be able to keep track of all night long as well. So anytime that you log in with us, you'll know immediately what the score is. And you can see that the time is counting down before we begin into the starting lineups and the national anthem. We got about 6:28 left. We had a chance to visit with Coach Scott McElravy earlier. We're going to try to play this interview for you if we can. It's kind of loud in here, but let's see if we can hear what Coach McElravy has to say.
Sectional championship game tonight, Fairfield Mules and Teutopolis Wooden Shoes. Coach McElravy is with us. Coach, what concerns you the most about the shoes tonight? What do the Mules got to do to win tonight?
Well, we've got to control the boards. Smith and Weber, you know, we've got to limit them as far as touches inside, you know, 5 to 8 feet. They're really, really good at posting up strong, you know. We're athletic. We're quick. I feel like we're quicker than them, but you just got to limit touches for them down low, the easy scores.
And as far as bench play, I like the depth that Fairfield has. I think your bench strength is much stronger than the shoes.
I think so too, you know, and you know, we get out and we pressure teams, and you know, the first time we play them, we turn them over, I think, 19 times, so that's key too. But yeah, that 4 minute mark-ish or so, then first quarter, you're going to see at least three coming in, and you know, we trust the process, and hopefully, you know, as the game goes on, we can wear them down a little bit.
All right, appreciate it. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Coach Scott McElravy, before tonight's game, 19 turnovers they forced on the T-Town Wooden Shoes the first time, Danny. That's key.
Well, you know, this Mules defense has done that to a lot of teams this season, and it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments T-Town is going to make out of this. They may have gave a preview down here on Wednesday night when they held the basketball for 4 minutes. But I'm not sure they can hold it 4 minutes against the Mules.
Yeah, I don't think the Mules will let them, because I think that they'll put pressure defense on them and won't allow them to, as the Mules come back out on the floor out of the locker room here. And, you know, if you take a look at the schedule and look at common opponents that they've played, you know, you've got some common opponents they've played, such as the Effingham Hearts, which both teams have beaten this year. KC Westfield, which T-Town beat and Fairfield lost to. But, you know, T-Town has played arguably a stronger schedule than Fairfield, and I think most people from Fairfield will admit that. The Wooden Shoes have faced Nashville, East St. Louis, Champaign Central, Bloomington Central Catholic, and they lost each one of those teams. But, you know, Danny, they probably gained some valuable experience from playing those tougher schools.
Well, you know, we've said all along all season, you just watch these teams that rise. The Woodlawn Cardinals are a team that has played pretty tough schedule, and I think you'll probably see it paying off. You have been all season here. Toward the end of the season and postseason, their kids don't rattle because they've been in these situations.
T-Town has some quality wins this year against Breeze Modern Day. They've also beaten Breeze Central. They've beaten Springfield Sacred Heart Griffin. They got a win against St. Thomas More, as well as Taylorville, Mattoon, and they had a knockdown dragout with Woodlawn just a couple of weeks ago during the senior night at Teutopolis, and Woodlawn Cardinals got the game down to 4 points within the last couple of minutes, but T-Town then won the game by 10. So, again, the Wooden Shoes have played a tough schedule this year. They're 28-5 in that schedule. The Mules are 32-2. The Mules have three tournament championships, including a regional championship for their fourth, and they would love to add a fifth trophy tonight with this sectional championship and punch their ticket to the Elite Eight Tuesday night down at the SIU Arena.
You know, we talk about the Fairfield schedule, but they've played the Casey Westfields. They've played a good Olney team. That's two of the teams that they got a loss, but it's like Rob Flanagan said from Olney about the loss. He thought they caught them on Tuesday night blahs.
Yeah.
It was coming off the big championship of the El Dorado Holiday Tournament, something the Mules worked very hard to get down there. They beat a good Heron team who's making a nice run over there in postseason. They're playing for regional championship tonight. And I thought a game they got here a while back with Effingham was a big booster for them.
Mm-hmm.
They trailed in that game. Probably put them in a position they hadn't been in a while.
Right.
And they were able to buckle down and come back and get that game. And I think some of those games are really going to help this Fairfield team here tonight.
The Teutopolis Wooden Shoes are coached by Chester Reeder. He's actually the third coach that T-Town has had in 5 years. They've been going through them. And, you know, you kind of wonder if they wish they never would have parted ways with Andy Fehrenbacher, because you look at what he did at T-Town during his tenure there. He took them to the Super Sectional four straight years in a row, and look what he's done at Salem, turning that program around.
Well, you just wonder what the thought process is when a guy won 82% of his games and you want to go a different direction.
Yeah. Chester Reeder, like I say, in his first year as the head coach. They've got two seniors on the team that are in the starting lineup, I should say. And those are the two guys we mentioned earlier, in Clint Weber and Dawson Smith. They are the leaders out there as far as their offense is concerned. And, again, they got some pretty good size. And it'll be a challenge again for the Mules tonight. But the Mules have the confidence in knowing they can beat T-Town, as they have done that already this year back during the tip-off classic up at Lawrenceville. How did both teams get here? Well, Fairfield reached the sectional, of course, by beating both Harrisburg and Carmi in the regional, and then they blew out Pena here Tuesday night. T-Town reached this game tonight by beating Robinson and St. Anthony in the regional, and then they beat Mount Carmel here in the semifinal the other night, 47-37. We're going to have the playing of our national anthem here in just a moment, so that's going to give us an opportunity to take a brief timeout, let you meet from some more of our sponsors, and then we will be right back with those lineups and all the play-by-play action here live on AreaSports.net.
Carter Turf and Tractor is now open in their beautiful new location on West Main Street in Fairfield in the former Save-A-Lot building. Carter Turf and Tractor is your area dealer for high-quality Kubota tractors in a variety of sizes, perfect for a landscaping business or to easily handle a variety of jobs around your home or farm. They can customize a solution for your needs. They also have the Kubota RTV utility vehicles for on-road and off-road transportation and hauling needs. When there's mowing or lawn work to be done, Carter Turf and Tractor has you covered with X-Mark riding mowers and walk-behind mowers. They also feature a good selection of Echo brand brush cutters, trimmers, and chainsaws, as well as Honda and Generac generators. Come in and see for yourself at the new Carter Turf and Tractor, open 8 to 5 Monday through Friday and 8 to 2 on Saturday.
Star-spangled banner yet?
national anthem here tonight at Vandalia High School, sung by one of the people on the staff here, I believe. And they had the official scorekeeper sing it on Tuesday night.
Yeah, yeah, you know.
Some talented people up here.
And here are tonight's
all right, starting lineups now for tonight's contest. First of all, the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes, who come in with a record of 28-5, coached by Chester Reeder in his first season as a head coach.
At one guard, a 5'10 junior, number 12.
5'10 junior, number 12 is Luke Ungren. Ungren's got the capability of shooting from the outside, but he's mainly out there for his ball handling. Number 14 is Evan Wormert. He's a 6'2 sophomore.
At 4-6'6 senior, number 10.
6'6 senior is Dawson Smith. He's the guy you got to watch on the perimeter for the Wooden Shoes. He's a senior, and he can fill it up out there. He's usually one of their two leading scorers. Mitch Hardick wears number 20. He is a 6'3 junior for the Wooden Shoes. And rounding out the starting five is their big guy in the middle, Clint Weber, at 6'7, wears number 24. So, again, their starting lineup includes Smith, Ungren, Wormert, Hardick, and Weber. And size-wise, they go 5'10, 6'2, 6'3, 6'6, and 6'7. Definitely some size out there, Danny.
Yes, there is. You know, it'd be interesting to see how the Mules handle this.
And I got to tell you, there is probably more Fairfield people here tonight than there is T-Town people, but there is a good crowd on both sides, but it is crazy in here tonight. Let's meet the Fairfield Mules right now. Number one is Reese Lee. He's a 6-foot senior for the Mules. Also an outstanding football player. Wyatt Gilbert, he's a defensive stopper out there for Fairfield, of course, 5'10 junior. Jazelle O'Neill, he'll run the point. He's a penetrator. He wreaks havoc on defense as well. 5'11 senior is O'Neill. Kane Hixonball, we like to call him the silent assassin. He's a 6'3 junior. And rounding out the starting five, Dr. Dunk. Brian Estes, 6'6 senior for the Mules. So again, they'll go with Lee, Gilbert, O'Neill, Hixonball, and Estes. And size-wise, the Mules go 5'10, 5'11, 6', 6'3, and 6'6. So again, a little size advantage for the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes. And about the 4-minute mark, Danny, you'll see three guys come off the bench for Fairfield who will come in and make a real impact in the game. And that, of course, is Luke Dagg and Cody Cantrell, and
Landon Zerlini.
Landon Zerlini, you bet. Glad that you're with us here live on AreaSports.net for this audio-only broadcast with our live interactive scoreboard so we can keep track of things for you. Again, the IHSA not permitting us to do video tonight, but we're glad that you tuned in with us anyway. You didn't have to pay a fee or a subscription to be here with us tonight. In the center circle, it is Weber and Estes, and the tip is going to be controlled by the Wooden Shoes. Wooden Shoes wearing their traveling blue uniforms tonight. And a man-to-man defense is employed by Fairfield, and that's a turnover right away. Good defense by O'Neill forces an immediate double dribble.
Forces first turnover number one.
Again, Fairfield forced 19 turnovers against the Wooden Shoes the first time they met way back in November. First offensive start here for the Mules now as O'Neill goes left side to Gilbert. He'll penetrate. Gives a backdoor pass intended for O'Neill, and it goes out of bounds. It's knocked out of bounds, though, by Dawson Smith of the Shoes. Out of bounds on the baseline for the Mules. It'll be triggered in by O'Neill, and he'll come out to Estes on the left corner. Looks like T-Town. Are they starting a man? Are they starting in the zone?
They're in a man.
Okay. Here's a shot from behind the arc. It's good. A three-pointer on the way by Wyatt Gilbert. A great start for the Fairfield Mules. They're up 3-0, and here comes that pressure defense, that 2-2-1 press. The Shoes get it across, and it's knocked away and stolen by Hixonball. It was slapped away by Estes. Hixonball got it. Here comes Reese Lee. Mules in the front court, leading it 3-0. Jazelle O'Neill, he's going to pop a three-pointer. It's in and out, no good. Ball's chased down in the corner, but off the fingertips of Reese Lee and out of bounds. It'll belong to the Wooden Shoes. A lot of intensity shown here early on by Fairfield, Danny.
The T-Town coach is already working the officials.
Shoes try to bring it across the timeline. As playing catch with Ungren is Smith. Smith gets it across, goes down low now to the big man. He's double teamed, goes up for the shot, and it rims in. As Weber puts it in and puts T-Town on the board at 3-2. Boy, the Mules were there on the double team, though, and they stayed straight up so they would not commit the foul. It was good defense. Mules now in the front court again with O'Neal out at the top. He's looking for a place to penetrate. Now he'll stop and pop. He got it. Three-pointer by Jazelle O'Neal. And the Mules have two back-to-back trifectas and lead it 6-2.
That's that step-back three.
He loves to shoot that shot. And he's very, very skilled at it. The Mules are looking to trap. Shoes get it across. As Wermert's got it. Goes left side now to Smith. Directing traffic in the high post, taken away by Estes. 3-on-2 break. Goes it ahead to Jazelle, but he bounces it off his leg and out of bounds. And, boy, a missed opportunity there by the Mules. Looked like they were going to get another layup, Danny.
Turnover number one on the Mules. Three on the Wooden Shoes.
But T-Town clearly struggling with their ball handling against this pressure defense early on by Fairfield. Billy Boy, if you're logged on watching with us, listening tonight, let us know how things are sounding there. Okay. And another turnover as Ungren was trying to play catch with Dawson Smith. They had not yet got it across the timeline, and they threw it away. And again, credit the Fairfield defense. 6-2, Fairfield leading it here in the early going. 5:47 to play, first quarter. Right side, they work it to Gilbert. Gilbert out to the high post now to Estes. They go inside to Hickson, ball in the lane. He spins on his man, puts up the shot. It's off, no good. Rebound ripped out of there by Weber for T-Town. He'll get the pass out to Ungren, and they will walk it up. They get it across the timeline as Ungren is hassled out there by O'Neal. Goes down the lane, almost a block shot. Rebound by Reese Lee. He throws it out to O'Neal, and here come the Mules. They limit him to one shot again. Reese Lee goes in the lane. Bounce passes it to Estes. From the baseline, it's no good. And on the rebound, we're going to have a foul called on Kane Hicksonball. And, boy, that was a tough call. There wasn't really much contact there at all, I didn't feel.
First foul of the game.
What'd you think, Danny? There's not much contact on that.
I've seen more banging right there already.
There was more banging on Tuesday night against Painter that they didn't call. Oh, well, that's a foul. Wermert had gotten the rebound. Now the Shoes have it. They carried it across the timeline. It's stolen away again by Reese Lee as he jumped in the passing lane. Another Wooden Shoe turnover. Reese Lee in the lane, goes up for the shot, has it blocked. Tried to do maybe a little too much himself that time. Probably should have given the ball up. T-Town gets it back in the corner, and it's stolen away again. Stolen this time by Wyatt Gilbert. He takes it down and lays it in. And the Mules are rolling on defense, and timeout T-Town. And listen to this crowd. Fairfield fans going crazy. 8-2 with 4:37 to go in the first quarter of play. Danny, your thoughts so far?
Well, the pressure defense for this Mules bunch is playing havoc right now. Six turnovers on T-Town. The Mules have had a couple other good looks. This thing could be out of hand already.
I'll tell you what, if you are Fairfield, this is the kind of start that you wanted to see. You wanted to get off to a good start tonight and get this crowd into the game, and it's buzzing. And the T-Town fans, meanwhile, are sitting on their hands. They got nothing to cheer about because it's been all Fairfield so far. Coming out of the timeout now, it will be Wooden Shoes basketball length of the floor.
This 2-2-1 press is pretty effective right now.
Dawson Smith will try to bring it up. He's playing catch with Ungren. Still not across the timeline. Now they do get it across. This time to Wermert. Wermert's out between the circles. It's thrown away almost. And knocked out of bounds by Zerlini, who's checked into the game. And he almost had a steal.
He had it twice.
Cantrell checks into the game for Fairfield. And Luke Dagg also in the game. So they came in just a little bit early. So you got the three super subs out there right now. Zerlini, Dagg, and Cantrell. And they're on the floor along with Gilbert and O'Neal for Fairfield. 4:19 to play here in the first quarter. T-Town goes inside the high post. Shot is up, and it's in by the big man,
Weber.
As Weber worked it in against Luke Dagg. 8-4. Mules back in the front court now. O'Neal has it between the circles. He comes over to Wyatt Gilbert. Gilbert directing traffic. Comes left side to Cantrell. Now out to the top to Zerlini. He'll penetrate, puts up a little runner, a little teardrop. It's no good. Rebound by Weber for T-Town as he had inside rebounding position on Dagg.
Had a good look.
Had a real good look. Just didn't go. In the front court come the shoes as they get it across now to Hardick. Hardick goes into the high post to Weber. He'll hand it off to Ungren. Well, I'll tell you, their passes have just been flimsy.
Going to have a foul on Gilbert.
They tried a bounce pass inside the lane, and Gilbert's going to be called for the hold. Stan Garner listening to us. Thank you, Stan. Appreciate the message. A lot of people joining us for this great Mules action tonight. Trying to advance to the Elite Eight for the first time since 1992. Here is the inbound to T-Town. They've got it out front now with Hardick. Hardick gives it up to Wermert. They try to go down low to the big man Weber. Here comes a double team by Fairfield, so they'll bring it back out to Wermert. Good defense by the Mules. 3:08 to play in the quarter. Mule fans getting loud now. Out front it comes to Ungren. Ungren gives it to Smith. Smith, they can't get a shot, Danny. Around the perimeter they work it.
Pretty good defense by the Mules right here.
Mules have extended their defense out beyond the arc. They are not going to give them a shot out there. Wermert gives it now to Smith. Smith directs traffic. They're going to try to reset the offense again.
Clear his side.
Nothing's happening as they come back out to Hardick. Hardick
walk.
Right side to Wermert. Wermert's going to force one up over Zerlini. It's no good. Battle for the rebound, and it's going to be a tie-up. Jump ball. And who's it going to be?
Possession's going to go to
the Mules. Officials are talking, and they're going to give it to Fairfield. Possession arrow. This T-Town had gotten the tip, so Mules get the ball. 2:32 to go here, first quarter. It's 8-4 in favor of the Mules, and I missed one on my scoreboard. I apologize. There we go, 8-4.
Come on, what are you doing?
I got too excited. This exciting game so far. Cantrell in the corner for the Mules. Goes in. There's a backdoor pass to Dagg. It's up and in. What a great pass by Hixonball to Dagg on the backdoor cut, and he laid it in off glass, and it's 10-4 Mules. Fairfield clicking on all cylinders right now. Now that defense is swarming again as the Wooden Shoes get it across the timeline, and they walk with the basketball. Falling down was Ungren because of the trap applied by the Mules. He falls down. It's a turnover, and it's back to Fairfield. 2:07 to play. Mules up 10-4. Heath Hamilton says, I'm listening in Pennsylvania. Great. Thanks, Heath. Hope you're enjoying it. It's exciting here. Mules taking their time now as between the circles, holding onto the basketball is Jayzel O'Neal. He's not actually holding it. He's dribbling it. He goes left side to Hixonball. Hixonball around a screen set by Dagg. It's a give and go. A pick and roll, and it's a bucket for Luke Dagg. A beautiful pick and roll executed to perfection that time by the Mules, and they go up by 8, 12-4. Smith back out in the front court for the Wooden Shoes. He goes left wing now. Stolen again by the Mules. Hixonball has it. Comes into the front court. Knocked out of bounds. It's going to be last touch by Smith. And the Mules are just eating them alive on defense. As Estes checks back in along with Reese Lee. Going to give Cantrell and O'Neal a blow here with a minute 27 to go in the quarter. It's Mules basketball. They lead it by 8, 12-4. Minute 27 left here, first quarter. Here's the inbound pass to Reese Lee. He has it between the circles. Now he hands it off to Landon Zerlini out there. Reese Lee back out to Dagg. Dagg comes way out to the top between the circles. Goes left side to Hixonball. Looks inside to Zerlini. And they're going to call him for double dribbling. That was a tough call, Danny, because he caught the ball, dropped it, but that counts as a dribble. Picked it up, then dribbled again.
4-3, Nashville leads after one.
Wow, low-scoring game. Does that mean Alton Marquette's holding the ball on Nashville?
I don't know.
Winner of this game gets the winner of Nashville and Alton Marquette. We'll keep you posted on that. They'll play Tuesday night at the SIU Arena. Will it be the Mules and the Hornets? If so, both teams would enter that game at 33-2. Identical records. I would love to see that. I know most Mule fans would, too. 52 seconds left in the quarter as the Wooden Shoes have it in the front court. Here's a backdoor pass and shot up and in. Somebody lost communication that time as Lucas Dries scores, who came off the bench on a backdoor play for the Wooden Shoes. 12-6. 35 seconds left in the quarter. Mules may run it down here. Let's see. No, Zerlini's going to take it down the lane and score. Nobody stopped his progress. He did a little teardrop down the lane. Zerlini scores, make it 14-6. Mules by 8. 22 seconds left in the quarter. Wooden Shoes has it stolen. Reese Lee has it. Pushes it for the Mules. Takes it down. Puts it up off glass. Off no good. Battle for the rebound. Goes out of bounds. Last touched by T-Town. Wermert hit it.
Boy, I'm not sure you couldn't have had a little basket interference.
I think you could have had some basket interference because he was way up above the rim, the Wooden Shoe player was, as that ball was coming off the glass and towards the rim. And we got an official coming over here at the scores bench. Let's see. What's he going to say? He's right in front of us. We are directly behind the scores bench. All right. 13 seconds left. Here's the inbound to Estes. Estes gives it to Reese Lee. Over to Zerlini. 9 seconds left. Zerlini on the left side. Goes around a screen looking for a shot. Dagg has it. Now to Reese Lee. He's looking for a shot. Penetrates inside. Down to Estes. And he slams it! Brian Estes slams it at the buzzer. And it counts! 16-6. What a quarter for the Mules, and what execution on that play, and this crowd is on fire. Wow. 16-6 Mules after one. Stay tuned, folks. We will be right back here in Vandalia.
It's the heating season, and Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods remind you that they have fast, reliable propane delivery service to your home or farm. And if you need those propane bottles filled up, you can bring them to Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods for fast service. Looking for a wide selection of guns and ammunition? You'll find it at Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods. You can even search online through our website at WainwhitePropane.com. And don't forget, we also have hot tubs and supplies for your hot tub as well at Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods, located on West Main Street in.
Welcome back to Vandalia. Randy Olson and Danny Ounsom at courtside here as we move into the second quarter now. Mules lead it 16-6. What an impressive set that was right before the end of the quarter, Danny.
You know, both teams are shooting pretty good. The Mules are 7 out of 10 to open the game. T-Town was 3 out of 4, but they only got 4 shots because of 9 turnovers.
Yeah, 9 turnovers in the first quarter by T-Town. Who would have thunk it? But again, that Mule defense will do that to you. As we start the second quarter, here's a backdoor play to Clint Weber, and he scores.
He's got 6 of the 8.
16-8. We said at the top of the broadcast that it was Weber at 6'7 and Smith at 6'6 are their scores. Smith plays on the perimeter, and Weber plays inside. Weber scored on that one, and here's Estes scoring around a pick, and he puts the Mules back up by 10, 18-8.
Nice pass from Hickson Ball.
Great execution by the Mules. I'm telling you, they are really, really running that offense well. T-Town in the front court. Here's a drive to the basket. No good. Rebound by Weber. He puts it back up and in. The Mules are going to have to box him out. Initial shot was missed by Wermer. The Weber was there for the stick back. It's 18-10. Here's a shot up front.
Oakville trails Madison 14-10 at the end of the first.
They trail Madison?
Yes.
Shot is missed by the Mules. Rebound by T-Town. Weber's going to take it all the way down, and he's going to be fouled on his way to the basket. And I think that's going to go on Wyatt Gilbert.
That'll be second one on Gilbert.
Weber to the line for the shoes. Mules, best third of the half.
And that's 3 team fouls on Fairfield. There have been no fouls called on T-Town as of yet. And we're in the second quarter. Write that one down. At the line is Clint Weber. And he misses the free throw. Fairfield led it after one, 16-6. It's 18-10 now. And the second free throw is also missed by Weber. Rebound by the Mules. Ahead to Zerlini. He's open for three. Missed it. Rebound weak side by the Wooden Shoes. They'll bring it back the other way. They get it up quickly this time to Weber. Now they'll back it out to Ungren. Ungren goes right side to Smith. Smith spins, puts up a shot, and it's short. Rebound. O'Neal gets it to Estes. The Mules will bring it up to Hicksonball. Hicksonball in the front court on the right side. Picks up his dribble. And they're going to be called for an offensive foul. Boy, that was a tough call, too. Hickson Ball was trying to clear some space for himself, tried to shield himself with his arm, and instead he's called for the push-off, Danny.
That's two on Hickson Ball.
Belleville Althoff leading Heron after one, 9-2. That's in 3A regional championship tonight. Heron's won, like, what, 20 games in a row since they lost to Fairfield at the El Dorado Holiday Tournament? Seth Verlier leads Woodlawn.
15-8.
15-8, yeah. All right, here we go. Ball goes back to T-Town, 18-10. They are in the front court. They've got it. 6-10 to play here in the second quarter after the foul on Hickson Ball. And there's a block from behind by Dagg. The ball goes out of bounds, though. And last touch by Zerlini. It'll be T-Town ball out of bounds on the baseline.
Coach McRaevy said, hey, guys, we got four and they got none.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I think he's got a point. There's been a lot of physicality out there both directions. I can't believe T-Town hasn't been called for at least one foul. In underneath is Smith, and he scores. 5:55 to play here in the half. Deals with a 6-point lead. They've led by as many as 10 on two occasions. Dagg's got it at the high post. Comes out now to Jazel O'Neill. It's almost like they're daring him to shoot it, and he's thought about it. Now he gives it back to Dagg. Now back to O'Neill. We got Estes, Zerlini, Dagg, Reese Lee, and Gilbert out there right now. Gilbert just inside, or not Gilbert, but O'Neill. O'Neill just inside the circle, misses the shot. Rebound by T-Town. They'll come back the other way. Left side, they work it to Ungren. Here's a shot from the corner by Smith. No good. Mules chase the rebound down in the corner. Zerlini's got it. Wraparound pass to Reese Lee, and here come the Mules. Quickly in the front court. And timeout's going to be called by Coach McElravy, and he's going to use that opportunity to talk to the official, too, Danny.
Yep.
Again, this broadcast being made possible by Frontier Community College. A reminder that summer and fall registration begins March 26th at Frontier Community College in Fairfield. You know, Frontier is rated the 15th best two-year trade school in America by Forbes magazine. That's Frontier Community College in Fairfield. What's your observation so far, Danny?
Well, you know, the Mules hit them pretty hard during that first quarter, but T-Town is kind of regrouped here a little bit, trying to work their way back into this deal. There was 9 turnovers in the first quarter.
They've done a better job of getting it across the half line here in the second quarter of play, and they've hit a couple of shots. Again, Clint Weber is a beast down there on the boards. The Mules have got to work on keeping him off the boards. He's had a stick back and a couple of other big rebounds in there to keep possessions alive for the Wooden Shoes. As we come back to live action, it's Mules basketball right in front of the scorer's bench. Reese Lee will trigger it in, and out between the circles with it is Jazel O'Neill. We've got O'Neill, Estes, Reese Lee, Dagg, and Zerlini on the floor for the Mules.
Gilbert and Hickson Balls both got 2 fouls.
They're both on the bench. As here's a shot from the elbow by O'Neill. No good. There's a rebound by Dagg. He puts it up and in. Big offensive rebound and stick back by Luke Dagg.
O'Neill's shot was partially blocked.
And what could you say about Dagg? When he comes in the game, he makes things happen. And he did again. Here's Smith out on the right side. He's going to drive inside, put up the shot. He missed it. Rebound Zerlini. And Zerlini will bring it up for the Mules. 4:29 to play here in the half. Mules up by 8. Zerlini on the right side. Picks up his dribble. Comes back out to Estes on the right wing. He'll drive baseline on his man on Weber. Comes back out to Zerlini. Shoes still in a man-to-man. Zerlini now all the way out between the circles. He's guarded out there by Lucas Dries, who's in the game. Now to Estes. And Estes going to be called for a traveling violation. I didn't see it, did you?
Turnover number 3. I thought he may have given that little shuffle step.
Cantrell into the game for them.
Thank Billy Rocket and Jeremy Varner for getting these scores.
Yeah, we do appreciate that, guys. Keeping us up to date on the other games so we can keep our listeners and viewers updated as well. Again, the winner of this game gets the winner of the Nashville Alton Marquette game. We're keeping you abreast of that, keeping you abreast of the Woodlawn Cesar game, which is 1A game. Wooden Shoes in the front court, trailing it by 8, 3:53 to play in the half. With it out front is Hardick. Hardick tries a backdoor pass to Smith, and it's blocked by Dagg, but they're going to call him for the foul. Dagg was there, looked like a good block.
little extracurricular activity.
And that's going to send Smith to the line. Dawson Smith, a 6'6 senior perimeter player for the Wooden Shoes. Again, Smith and Weber are typically their leading scorers. Smith's free throw is no good. She's 0 for 3 so far at the line.
Well, that's his first two. Weber missed two, but the Shoes were 0 for 3.
0 for 3.
Is that what you said?
That's what I meant. That's the team. Okay. It's hard to hear each other, isn't it? It's pretty loud in here. Five team fouls on Fairfield. None. No fouls called at all on T-Town. And we've played a quarter and a half, and they have yet to be whistled for a foul. I'll let you make your own thought about that. Here's O'Neill out front. Shot is up. No good. Rebound. Cantrell. He sticks it in. Cantrell with the offensive rebound and stick back. And the Mules tearing them up on the offensive glass. T-Town gets it across quicker this time. Here's a wraparound pass down low to Weber. He missed the bunny. Rebound Cantrell. And my, oh my, they call a foul on T-Town. Can you believe it? Not until 3:17 of the second quarter, but they finally call a T-Town foul. And that foul is going to be charged to Mitch Hardick, the 6'3 junior. 10-point Mule lead as they'll bring it up with 3:13 to go in the half. Jazelle O'Neill between the circles. Goes into Estes at the high post. He'll hand off to Cantrell. Cantrell looks to penetrate. Does. Goes in the lane. Leaves it for Estes. He puts up an 8-footer. Missed it. And on the rebound, they're going to get O'Neill with a foul, I believe. Or they just say knocked out of bounds. Nope, they're going to get him with a foul.
His first. Fifth on the Mules.
Actually, that's going to be the sixth on the Mules with that foul.
Should have looked at my book. I looked at the board.
Yeah. T-Town throws it down. That's got to be a charge. Nope. We're going to call a blocking foul on Estes. T-Town took it strong to the glass with Smith. He ran over Estes. Estes called for the block. Mules can't catch a break as far as the fouls are concerned here. Smith back at the line. They count the bucket. It actually went in, so it's 22-14. And an and-one free throw coming for Dawson Smith. Now, that was a big play, Danny.
Yes, it was.
Smith is good on the free throw. And that cuts it to 7, 22-15. 2:54 to play here in the first half. Mules have led by as many as 10 on two occasions. And, again, they've got a couple guys on the bench with two fouls apiece. Hickson Ball and Wyatt Gilbert.
Gilbert went to the bench at the 6:34 mark.
Mules have it in the front court. Cantrell on the left wing. Now to Dagg. Dagg's going to shoot from the baseline. He missed it. Ball is chased down in the corner, picked up by Smith. He's going to throw it ahead to Hardick. Hardick gets it over on the right wing to Wormert, and he nails a three. Wormert brings T-Town to within 4 points. It's 22-18. Now the T-Town fans making some noise as we're surrounded by many of them. Here is Zerlini on the other side, and that's going to be a foul.
On Dagg.
What is that?
Foul on Dagg.
How is that a foul on Dagg? Oh, you mean away from the basketball?
Yeah. Holding on a pick.
Zerlini shot the basketball behind the arc. It looked like Zerlini got fouled, actually, and I thought that Zerlini was going to shoot three free throws, but instead they call a foul away from the ball on Dagg, and now the officials are conferring with each other. And Coach McElravy is wanting an explanation from the official who made the original foul call. As they sort that out, they're going to give T-Town the ball with 2:16 to play here in the first half. The Shoes have cut the lead to 4.
Gilbert, Hickson, Ball, and Lee back for the Mules.
8 fouls called on the Mules, 1 on T-Town.
That is
a travel that they missed for sure. They come into the high post to Weber. Weber now to Hardick out front. Almost a steal by Hickson Ball, who's back in the game playing with 2 fouls. Gilbert's back in the game playing with 2 fouls as well, as he is guarding Smith out front. Almost a steal as they're surrounding Smith, double teaming him. Now the Shoes come out to Ungren between the circles. They try to work it down low to Weber. He walked with the ball. He dropped the ball, picked it back up. Now they're going to come out for a 3-point shot. That's missed. Rebound underneath, put up and in by Wormer. Wermert with an offensive stick back cuts the game to a two-point game, 22-20.
That silenced the Mules crowd and brought T-Town alive.
Mules need a bucket. Here's a steal by the Shoes. Goes out of bounds. Going to be Fairfield basketball right at the midcourt stripe. Business is picking up, Danny.
Yes, it is. Turnover number 10 on T-Town, 5 on the Mules.
Mules need a bucket here. It's 22-20. With a minute 13 to go in the quarter, and out between the circles is Jazel O'Neal, and there's a steal by T-Town. Back the other way they go. Shot is put up, no good. Rebound Wyatt Gilbert. Brings it back for the Mules. Estes has it. He's going to come out to Jazel O'Neal. O'Neal, with 53 seconds left, is going to turn around and look at Coach as he continues his dribble between the circles. He's guarded out there by Dawson Smith, comes right side. Now they give it to Estes at the circle. Inside it comes to Cantrell to Hicksonball. Now out to Reese Lee, and they'll reset again.
15-7 Nashville at the half. 19-19 Madison Oakville tied at the half. And Sesser leads Woodlawn 25-11 midway through the second.
Foul's called on the Wooden Shoes. They reached in on Hicksonball. It's a non-shooting foul. It'll be out of bounds to the Mules on the baseline with 28 seconds left here in the half. That's only the second team foul on T-Town. Eight fouls have been called on the Mules. Back in the ballgame, Landon Zerlini for the Mules, replacing Hicksonball, who goes back to the bench with two fouls. So the Mules have Reese Lee, Zerlini, Estes, and both the guards, Gilbert and O'Neal, in the ballgame right now. As the inbound comes into Estes, and he's going to be called for traveling.
Turnover number six.
I don't know if he got careless with that after he caught the pass or what. Things unraveling here a little bit for the Mules. They got to play some defense and keep the Shoes from scoring here. Two-point game with 22 seconds left as P-Town will play it for one shot, I'd say. They get it across the timeline. With it out front is Smith. He is hassled out there by Wyatt Gilbert. Smith still between the circles. Gilbert right up on him. Here comes a screen. Now they go right side with it. Long three is put up. It's no good by Wermer. Battle for the rebound. Jump ball is going to be called. And possession arrow is going to give it to Fairfield with 0.8 seconds left here in the first half. So the Mules will probably just throw it length of the floor here.
Sesser leads at halftime 30-15.
That was almost a foul, but they don't call anything. As the shot is put up in the half line, that's the end of the first half. Our score here at halftime, it's Fairfield 22 and Teutopolis 20. And we'll come back and take a look at the first half stats. And we're going to have Hamilton County coach Doug Miller on with us for a moment, too, to kind of get an input on what he thinks of this first half as well. We'll do all that coming up next here on Area Sports. Welcome back here to Vandalia, Randy Olson courtside here, and I'm joined by Coach Doug Miller of the Hamilton County Foxes, who's here among a lot of coaches that are watching this game. And your thoughts on that first half play, Doug?
I think the first quarter, Fairfield's press gave T-Town lots of trouble.
Right.
But the foul trouble took Fairfield, their good presses, out of the first half.
Right.
So then P-Town broke their press much easier with the subs in.
Yeah, Fairfield got up 16-6 there after the first quarter, and then when Fairfield got into some foul trouble with Gilbert with two and Hicksonball with two, that kind of changed the dynamic in the second quarter, didn't it?
They sure did, and Fairfield could have easily been up by 15 or 20, but the foul trouble really killed them.
Yeah, it has. Anything else you observed about that first half?
T-Town needs to get the ball inside of their big guys, and it gave Fairfield lots of trouble, I thought.
Right. Fairfield's going to have to do a good job of trying to box Weber out because he's been a beast on the boards.
I don't know how many he has, but he's probably got half the points.
Yeah, and he's got a lot of rebounds as well. But also, you got to tip your hat to Fairfield on the offensive rebounds and stickbacks that they've had, too. They've had some big plays underneath.
And their role players are getting rebounds and putting them back in, which is huge for Fairfield.
Right. The guys that have come off the bench have done really well for Fairfield, and that's just kind of showing how important that depth is that Fairfield's had all year.
But that's been their success the whole year.
You bet.
You know, 1 through 12 is pretty good basketball players for Fairfield.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Well, Doug, we appreciate you joining us here, and I'm sure you're enjoying the game, and let's see what the Mules can do second half, all right?
I mean, it's a great atmosphere for a basketball
game. Oh, man, isn't it, though? It's loud.
Is.
Loud and crazy.
Thanks a lot.
All right, appreciate it. Doug Miller, the Hamilton County Foxes coach, joining us here at halftime. Again, the Mules lead it 22-20. They led it by 10 at the first quarter stop, 16-6, and had another 10-point lead midway through the second quarter. As Danny's working on our stats, we'll share with you that at halftime, Belleville Althoff leads Heron 20-12, and Cesar Valier leads Woodlawn 30-15 at the half, so that's a bit of a surprise. Also in Class 1A regional championship game tonight, Mawikawa Central A&M leads Nokomis 31-27. Nashville leads Alton Marquette 15-7 at the half. So Danny's going to rejoin us here, and we'll take a look at these first half stats. Again, remind you that this game also made possible by Frontier Community College, where summer and fall registration begins March 26th at Frontier Community College in Fairfield. Don't forget, Frontier is rated the 15th best two-year trade school in America by Forbes magazine. That's Frontier Community College in Fairfield. Danny, you got some first half stats there for us. What'd you think?
Oh, yeah. The Mules had kind of a bad second quarter, Randy. They shoot 3 out of 10 in that quarter. They were 7 out of 10 to open the game, 3 out of 10 in that quarter. So that makes them 10 out of 20 for 50% at the half. Not attempted a free throw in the game. They have 6 turnovers. For T-Town, they're 9 out of 18 on field goals for 50%. 1 out of 5 from the free throw line. And have 10 turnovers. The pressure early on was bothering the shoes quite a bit till the Mules got in a little bit of foul trouble and
right.
The intensity level kind of dropped off. Leading T-Town is Weber with 8. Smith has 5. And a bunch of guys have 2. For the Mules, they're being led by Wyatt Gilbert has 5. O'Neill has 3. Estes has 4. Luke Dagg has 6. Cantrell has 2 to round out the scoring here in the first half. Mules only put 6 points. It was 16 to 6 after 1. It's 22-20 here at half. So they got outscored 14-6 that quarter. Got an updated score. Mawika A&M leads Nokomis 31-27 at the half. The winner of that plays Cesar, Woodlawn's winner.
Mm-hmm. And Cesar is leading Woodlawn 30-15.
At the half, Althoff leads Heron 20-12. Nashville's ahead of the team they're playing 15-7. Cesar leads at the half.
Mm-hmm.
So Alton's who's Nashville's
playing.
Alton
Marquette, yeah. And Fairfield or T-Town gets the winner of that game, the Nashville-Alton Marquette game. The winner of this game plays the winner of that game Tuesday night at the SIU Arena. So right now, Nashville leads Alton Marquette 15-7.
Oakville-Madison's tied 19-19 at the half.
And in the 3A regional championship at Salem, Highland leads Salem at halftime 30-19. So a lot of big basketball going on around the area. I'm a bit surprised by that Cesar Valier-Woodlawn score. How about you?
Yeah, I think a lot of people are.
Here it's 22-20. What do the Mules have to do in the second half to be successful here, Danny?
Well, I think they got to come back with that pressure defense. And I think you got to hope the foul situation gets evened up here a little bit in this half.
Again, eight first half fouls called on Fairfield and only two on Teutopolis, and they didn't get their first foul of the game called on them until more than midway through the second quarter. So definitely not an equal situation there at all in terms of the fouls called. And it's been a pretty physical game on both sides. As the Fairfield fans cheer, as the Mules come back out on the floor, we've got 3:27 to go here before the start of the second half. Yeah,
both teams. Well, T-Town's just coming back.
Mules got to stay out of foul trouble, of course. Why don't you run through that foul situation for the Mules right now, all the way up and down the lineup.
Wyatt Gilbert has two. Jazelle O'Neill has one. Kane Hicksonball, two. Brian Estes, one. And Luke Dagg, two. For T-Town, Mitch Hardick has two. So that's 2, 4, 6, 7, 8-2 on fouls the first half.
Mm-hmm. And typically, their big man, Clint Weber, has been foul prone this year, and he got in foul trouble the other night against Mount Carmel with two fouls in the first half. But again, he does not have any fouls here in the first half tonight against the Fairfield Mules.
And like I said, 10 turnovers for T-Town, and 9 of those were in the first quarter.
Mm-hmm. While we got a couple minutes here, Danny, let's talk about the fact that next season things are going to change in terms of 2A and 1A basketball, as there's going to be a lot more meat added to the 2A stool next year that you can chow down on, because dropping down into 2A next year are going to be Salem, Benton, Carterville, Massac County, Columbia,
Heron,
Murfreesboro. No, Heron actually will stay 3A. They just missed the cut. Murfreesboro, Freeburg, Breeze Central, Breeze Modern Day, all those teams are going to be 2A next year, along with Fairfield, T-Town, and what have you. And then in the meantime, schools dropping down to 1A will be Edwards County, Casey, Westfield, and Red Hill. So that's going to really change the landscape of 2A and 1A basketball next year, won't it?
Yeah, what's scary is this T-Town team is about 20 students away.
Yeah, they've got an enrollment this year of 323. The cutoff between 1A and 2A is 299 students. That's locked in for the next 2 years. But if enrollments continue to drop, as people continue to leave Illinois, I think you're going to see the potential for Teutopolis to drop down far enough to where they may, in a few years, become 1A. I mean, it's not impossible, because who would have thought that Salem would drop down to 2A? They've never been 2A. But they're going to be next year. All right, both teams have been called back to their respective benches. As we're going to have second half action here. Glad you're with us here on AreaSports.net. Again, special thanks to our sponsors, who include Wayne White Propane and Sporting Goods, as well as Jagger's Doggy Daycare, FNB, Fairfield National Bank, Frontier Community College, Carter Turf and Tractor, all of Fairfield.
T-Town will have the ball to open the quarter, so they could tie it right here off the bat.
They could. Mules have their original starters back on the floor to start this second half. And the inbound pass comes into Ungren. Unwin works on Jazelle O'Neill, works it left side to Smith. There's the alley-oop as they throw it to Weber. Weber scores. He didn't dunk it, but he got it in off glass, and it's tied at 22-22. First time we've been tied since 0-0. Mules in the front court. O'Neill's going to work it on the left wing. Now comes back out between the circles. Wooden Shoes are really, really sagging in the paint to try to keep O'Neill from penetrating and driving. Here is Estes with a 15-footer, and he got it. Estes puts the Mules back in front, 24-22.
Mules needed to answer there.
They needed that in a hurry. Here's Weber down low, and he missed a shot, but he's going to be fouled by Estes. Wooden Shoes doing a much better job of getting the ball down the court now and avoiding the trap. And they're doing that, Danny, by making longer passes. Have you noticed that?
Yes.
They're throwing longer passes up the sideline. At the line for two shots, it's Clint Weber, the big man. He puts the first one in. It's 24-23. That's the adjustment that the Wooden Shoes have made against the Fairfield press, is they're breaking it by throwing that long pass instead of the guards getting trapped before the half line. Second free throw's missed. Hicks the ball with the rebound. Mules lead it by one. Again, we're just underway here in the third quarter of play.
T-Town's kind of turned up the defense a little
bit.
Yeah,
they have. They have. They're still in a man, but they're really, really sagging in the paint, like I say, to try to keep that penetration down from the Fairfield guards. O'Neill has it on the left side. He's going to pull up for a three. He missed everything. Way off. Rebound by Wermert for T-Town. The ball goes out of bounds, and it's last touch by the Mules. Mules need to dial it back up on defense now. Do what got them here. Here is the inbound to Dawson Smith. Smith's going to bring it up against Jazelle O'Neill. He's across the timeline, works it left wing now to Hardick. He'll stay in that man-to-man. Hardick around a screen, picks up his dribble, goes to Weber. Weber against Estes. Now comes back out on the right wing to Hardick. Back to Weber, gets it down low and scores. When he gets it down that low, he's pretty hard to stop, Danny.
Yes, he will be.
T-Town.
First lead of the night.
Yep, T-Town takes their first lead here at 25-24 at 6:09 of the third quarter. Here's a long three from the corner by the Mules. No good by Wyatt Gilbert. Rebound T-Town. They want to push it, and it's blocked. Blocked by Kane Hixenbaugh, but then stolen by the Shoes. With it is Ungren. He'll fire from the corner, and he got it. Ungren with a three-point dagger. That puts T-Town up by four, 28-24. And this game has turned around, and T-Town is on fire, and timeout is called by the Fairfield Mules.
Again, congratulations to Clint Weber on his...
Well, a couple situations happened there, Danny. The Mules did a good job of getting the rebound there after the block, but then they didn't go meet the pass. And when you don't go meet the pass, these T-Town Wooden Shoes will jump in that passing lane and steal it, and that's exactly what they did. And then the three-point bomb was made from the corner, and the Shoes have gone up by four.
Shoes have kind of come out on fire this second half. They are three out of three, one out of two from the free throw line.
28-24 Shoes. Mules led it 22-20 at the half. So it's been an 8-2 run to start the second half here for Teutopolis. 5:45 to play here in the third quarter. Again, the winner gets the winner of Nashville and Alton Marquette Tuesday night down at the SIU Arena in the Elite Eight. And we're keeping track of that game for you. Nashville leading at a halftime. All right, back to live action. The Mules have it. They need a bucket here. Down by four. Wyatt Gilbert has it on the right side. Comes to Estes at the top of the key. Reese Lee tries to pound it down to Hixenbaugh. He works baseline. He's cut off. Comes back out to Reese Lee. Right side now. They go to Jazelle O'Neill. O'Neill comes out to Wyatt Gilbert. Gilbert goes inside the lane. Puts up a scoop shot. Scores off glass. Wyatt Gilbert did a nice job of kind of weaving his way through the big guys that time.
Yeah, he worked his way in, got a nice shot. The Mules needed that bucket.
Cuts the lead to two. It's 28-26. Wooden Shoes in the front court again. With it on the left wing is Wermert. Wermert comes out to the top of the key. Now swings it right side to Dawson Smith. He'll come out to the top. He hands it off to Wermert out there. Now right side Smith. He'll drive baseline, falls down, puts up the shot, gets his own rebound, puts it back up and in. Dawson Smith scores on the second effort for T-Town. 30-26, Shoes by four.
Heron on a 9-0 run to start the half. They lead off now 21-20.
Boy, that Heron bunch is resilient, aren't they? Man, oh man. They have been on a roll since losing to Fairfield back at the El Dorado Holiday Tournament.
On like 19 in a row.
19 or 20 in a row, yeah. And Belleville Althoff, we know they're no slouch. That's a good basketball team they're playing tonight. 4:21 to go here in the third quarter. Reese Lee picks up his dribble, comes way back out front. As the Mules have it to O'Neal. O'Neal gives it to Estes. 15-footer's good. They're leaving Estes open on that 15-footer, and he's knocking it down, Danny.
Yeah, and he needs to.
Cuts a lead to two. Mules back off and pick him up half court. Here's an alley-oop, but almost a stolen. They try to swing it left wing now to Dawson Smith. They're trying to post up Weber, and they get the alley-oop down to him, the lob, and he's fouled by the weak side help.
Reese Lee.
Reese Lee was coming over weak side to try to help as Estes was fronting Weber. They lobbed it over both Estes and Weber. Reese Lee came over to try to help but committed the foul. And that'll send Weber to the line.
Mawika A&M leads Nokomis 37-33 halfway through the third. Weber just went over 1,000 points on a basket earlier in this quarter.
And he scores on that free throw to put the shoes up by 3, 31-28. We've got 3:50 to play here in the third quarter. Another one by Weber is good. 32-28.
28 points is not enough for the Mules. It's too slow a pace.
Yeah. Yeah, Mules got to...
Got to
turn up the motor here a little bit. As Hickson Ball is going to bring it up, and here comes some pressure defense by the shoes. They get it across. Hickson Ball has it on the right wing and loses the basketball. Stolen away by Ungren. Ungren bounce passes it to Hardick, and he scores. Actually, Lucas Graves has scored on that, and it's a 6-point shoes lead. Check that. Yeah, it is a 6-point lead. And on the ensuing play, we've got a reach-in foul going to be called on the shoes as the Mules got it across the timeline.
Foul's going to be on Dre's.
That's the first foul on the shoes this half. Two have been called on the Mules. And Dre's, that's his, his first?
First. Yeah. First.
Fairfield ball out of bounds on the baseline as triggering in will be Wyatt Gilbert. Gilbert comes into Luke Dagg, who's in the ballgame now. And he gets it to Zerlini. Zerlini way out front. Puts up a three. Missed it. Rebound by Dagg. Tries to tip it out. And it's taken into the hands of Dawson Smith. And he's going to take it down to put up the shot. And he's going to be fouled, I believe, by Hickson Ball. They're going to count that?
They're going to count that basket. Said basket interference on Dagg.
Wow. Unbelievable. You know, we had a situation earlier that easily could have been basket interference on T-Town that they just looked the other way on, but this one they call, and that was questionable at best. 3:08 to play here in the third quarter. T-Town up by 8. At the line is Dawson Smith for the and one after the foul is called on Hickson Ball, and that is his third personal foul. Free throw is good by Smith. T-Town by 9. Their biggest lead of the game. Mules get it across the timeline.
Foul's going to be on Ungard.
As soon as the Mules got it across the line, they were fouled. It's going to be the second team foul and only the first on Ungren. Again, not many fouls called in this game on T-Town. Only two in the first half and two in the second half. Hickson Ball will go to the bench with 3 fouls. On the floor right now for the Mules is Cantrell, Dagg, Gilbert, Zerlini, as the pass comes into Dagg, and Estes. Those are the 5 on the floor for Fairfield right now. 2:59 to go, third quarter.
Mules need a bucket this trip.
They need a bucket badly. Cantrell has it between the circles. Comes to Zerlini on the right side. Boy, he is hassled out of there by Lucas Graves, and he's going to be called for a foul. Graves is chest bumping him out there when he's guarding him. I mean, literally chest bumping him. He's that close to him. They called him for the foul. It'll be his second. Out of bounds on the baseline to the Mules as Wyatt Gilbert's going to lob it in. And it's a steal by the shoes. 2-on-1 break, and it's a slam dunk by Dawson Smith. And that ignites the T-Town crowd. slammed by Smith, puts T-Town up by 11. And timeout called by Fairfield. 2:35 to play here in the third quarter.
19-6 run.
Yep. Yes, it is. A 19-6 run here in the second half for the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes as they lead it by 11. We'll take a brief timeout, and we will be right back.
Are you going out of town for a vacation or a weekend getaway? What are you going to do with your dog? That's easy. There's Jagger's Doggy Daycare in Mount Vernon. Jagger's Doggy Daycare is your one-stop shop for overnight dog boarding, doggy daycare, as well as dog grooming, and obedience dog training. It's your dog's home away from home, and they will thrive, and they'll get one-on-one attention by a great staff. More information is available on the web at jaggersdoggydaycare.com. Jagger's Doggy Daycare, 414 Main Street in Mount Vernon.
Back to live action here at Vandalia. Randy Olson along with Danny Anselment. The Mules trail it here by 11, and they have the ball out of bounds on the baseline. Still a lot of basketball left to be played. No reason to panic yet. This Fairfield team is resilient, but they got to get some points here. Wyatt Gilbert's going to drive, spins in the lane, puts up the shot, got it, banked it in. Big play by Wyatt Gilbert. Cuts the lead back to 9. Now the Mules defense needs to go to work. 2:18 to play, third quarter. Across the timeline comes Ungram. Here's the alley-oop for Weber, and it's taken by Dagg. Dagg brings it out, and it's stolen away by the Shoes. Smith has it. And a foul is going to be called on the Mules.
Wyatt Gilbert, that'll be his third.
Gilbert tried to chase Smith down along the sideline as he had a breakaway. And he's going to be called for his third personal foul.
Lead, five,
that's four Lee team fouls on the Mules this half. 2:02 to play here in the third quarter. Smith gets the pass inside, goes up for the shot, missed it, but he's fouled by Luke Dagg.
Be three on Dagg.
The Wooden Shoes are attacking the basket, Danny.
Yes, they are.
I mean, they are getting it, and they are going. They are attacking the basket, and the Mules have got to play defense. Free throw by Smith.
That was on number 30, Dagg, his third personal.
He missed that, right?
Made it.
They don't have it on the board.
They just put it on
there. Yeah, okay. I looked down for just a second. 40-30, back to a 10-point lead. Cantrell checks back in for Dagg in the Mules lineup. So the Mules have O'Neal, Reese Lee, Estes, Cantrell, and Zerlini on the floor right now. Second free throw by Smith is good. T-Town struggled early in the first half with free throws, but they're hitting them now. Zerlini has the ball in the front court. He'll drive baseline, puts up the shot, no good. Rebound by Weber. Weber's been big on the glass for the Wooden Shoes, and they limit Fairfield to one shot. Across the timeline comes Ungren for the Shoes. Ungren picks up his dribble, comes in the high post to Weber. Here's a shot, put up, no good. Rebound Estes. He's going to clear it out to O'Neal. Fairfield needs another bucket. Down by 11. O'Neal takes it inside. He's going to be fouled. And who are they going to give it on? Are they going to give it to Weber, or are they going to give it
to
Hardick?
Number 30, they're going to give it to Dries. That's three on him.
Well, Dries has been the one that's been chest bumping Zerlini out there. That's going to send Jazel O'Neal to the line for Fairfield. Stops the clock with a minute 27 left here in the third quarter. Yeah, you were right what you said earlier, Danny, that the Wooden Shoes have really turned up their defense a couple notches.
Sesser leads 38 to 20 halfway through the third. Mawika A&M 47-38. Over Nokomis.
So the winner of Nokomis and Mawikwa gets the winner of Woodlawn Sesser.
And Sesser leads 38-20 halfway through the third.
That's amazing. Woodlawn down by 18. Free throw by O'Neal was good on the first one. Cuts it back to 10. The second free throw also good. Those are big free throws for Fairfield. Cuts the lead back to 9. Minute 27 to go here in the third quarter. Fairfield's going to back off the press. Going to pick them up at half court.
End of three. Nashville leads 24-14.
Walking it up is Ungren for T-Town. Now here comes the trap. T-Town gets it across to Smith. Boy, he almost traveled with that basketball. Mule fans thought he did. They're trying to get it inside to Weber. They pick up the ball out front to Hardick. Now down to Weber. He puts up the shot, missed it. Estes with a huge rebound for the Mules.
Big miss.
Clears it out to Reese Lee. Now out to the top of the key. Lee will shoot a three-pointer. It's no good. And it's rebounded by Wormer. Not sure that that's what the Mules wanted shot-wise. They could have gotten that earlier. Need to get it inside with a high percentage shot. Down by 9. 42 seconds to go. Shoes have it. Wormer out between the circles again to Hardick. Now he'll give it off out there to Ungren. Coming way out to get it to Weber. And that's going to be a foul on Reese Lee.
3-2 on Lee.
Lee went for the steal but wasn't there fast enough. Stops the clock with 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter. T-Town by 9, 41-32 as you see on our scoreboard. Weber will trigger it in right in front of us at the scores bench. And they'll come to Dawson Smith. Highland leads Salem after three quarters. 45-27.
Yeah, 45-27. Just got it.
That's a 3A regional. Here's a steal by Jayzel O'Neill. That was a foul. They didn't call it. O'Neill still penetrates. There's another foul, but instead it's a steal. And that's a traveling violation. I didn't think they were going to call it. Dawson Smith made the basket, but they wave it off and do call a traveling violation. And I'll tell you what, T-Town is getting some breaks, folks. They did call the traveling on that one.
7.7 left here in the third quarter.
Let's see if the Mules can get a quality shot off here at the end of the quarter. Jayzel O'Neill's going to spot up for a three. He does, and he got it! Boy, that's a big bucket for Fairfield. Huge bucket. Three-pointer by the Mules by Jayzel O'Neill. That cuts the lead to 41-35 at the end of three quarters of play. We'll come back with the fourth quarter here in just a moment live on AreaSports.net.
It's the heating season, and Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods remind you that they have fast, reliable propane delivery service to your home or farm. And if you need those propane bottles filled up, you can bring them to Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods for fast service. Looking for a wide selection of guns and ammunition? You'll find it at Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods. You can even search online through our website at WainwhitePropane.com. And don't forget, we also have hot tubs and supplies for your hot tub as well at Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods, located on West Main Street in.
Welcome back to Vandalia. Randy Olson and Danny Anselment courtside here as we get ready to move into the fourth quarter. Danny, your thoughts on that third quarter play?
Well, the Mules were 5 out of 10, Randy, 2 out of 2. But T-Town come out, shot 7 out of 10 that quarter and 6 out of 7
wow.
from the free throw line.
Wow. They went on a 19-8 run, was it, for
yeah.
a period there? And the Mules had a little bit of a run of their own there to end the quarter. Fairfield has the ball first to start this fourth and final quarter. Here's Zerlini for three. Off the back iron, no good. Boy, that would have been a big shot.
He's not scored.
Dawson's
at the end of three, Cesar over Woodlawn, 42-25.
Wow. Mules trying to trap now as the shoes have in the front court with Wormer. They'll go left wing now to Ungren. Ungren back out to the top to Wormer. Shoes lead it by 6. Here's the pass inside to Weber, and he scores. He got the ball way too deep that time. Mules can't let him get it in there that deep. That's disastrous.
Heron's tied after 3:37 all.
Wow, that's quite a game with Althoff and Heron. Mules down by 8. Here's Gilbert. Spins inside the lane, and he's going to be fouled by Ungren.
That'll be the second on him.
Stop the clock, and it'll send Wyatt Gilbert to the line to shoot a pair of free throws with 7:11 to go in the ball game.
If you're the Mules, you got to have these free throws.
Got to have these free throws down 8.
Fouls on Trent Weber.
Still a lot of basketball left. You give T-Town credit defensively. They've taken a lot of things away from the Mules tonight.
Wyatt, 36 points is not enough in the fourth quarter for the Mules.
No, this has been at T-Town's pace tonight. Second one is also good. And the Mules have got to do a better job on keeping Weber from getting the ball down low. T-Town back in the front court. Way out front with it is Ungren. They're looking towards Weber. They want to try to get it into him. Zerlini is on him. And timeout's going to be called by Teutopolis. Yeah, he did save him because that was about a five count. As the Mules defense was about to get the turnover on the five count. Timeout with 6:53 to go in the ball game as T-Town leads it by six here, 43-37. What do the Mules need to do here, Danny?
Well, they're going to have to turn the pressure up, Randy. You know, when they were really going good in that first quarter, they was getting turnovers left and right.
Got to have some stops.
Massac leads Carbondale 14-11 at the end of one. That's a surprise.
That is a surprise.
At the end of three, Cesar 42, Woodlawn 25. That's a surprise. Not that they're ahead, but by that much.
I don't think anybody saw that game being a blowout either direction, really. Those two teams had played twice each this year and had split their two meetings this year. So for Cesar to be blowing Woodlawn out, that is a surprise. All right, back to live action. Wooden Shoes have it. Hardick goes on the right side to Wermert. Back out the top to Ungren. They want to get it into Weber. He comes to the high post. They can't get him the ball. Now they go right wing to Wermert. Mules trying to trap if they can. Shoes trying to run some clock as Hardick is playing catch out there with Wermert. Mules trying to trap to get a steal or jump in that passing lane. Shoes with that comfortable 6-point lead. Boy, that was a dangerous pass as they skipped a pass over and the Mules almost intercepted it. Back out front to Wermer. There's a kick. Oh, man. Wyatt Gilbert kicked the ball. He almost had a steal there, Danny.
Madison 40, Oakville 37 after three.
Jordan Hardick in the game now for the Shoes. So they got both Hardicks out there. Jordan and Mitch. Ungren will trigger it in right by the half line after the kick by the Mules. Reese Lee's going to check back in for the Mules. So the Mules have Estes, Hixonbaugh, O'Neill, Gilbert, and Lee out there. The original starters are on the floor with 6:13 to play in the game. All right, here's the inbound to T-Town. They got it between the circles with Wermert. Right side, they're going to work it. Three-pointer on the way. It's no good by Hardick. Chased down, and foul's going to be called on Hardick. That's Jordan Hardick, the one that just checked into the game for the Shoes, and he's called for the foul. And that's going to be foul number six on the Wooden Shoes. So Mules will be in the bonus.
Each team's got six.
Yep, both teams will be in the bonus on next fouls. Yeah, a lot of basketball left here. 6:03, 6-point game. Mules need a bucket this trip. Here's the inbound to O'Neill. O'Neill comes left side to Wyatt Gilbert. Gilbert around a pick. Goes down the lane. Puts up the shot. Missed it. Battle for the rebound. Smith comes away with it. And he throws the outlet. But it's stolen by O'Neill and stolen back by T-Town. Smith has it. In the corner to Weber. Weber spins on Estes. Puts up the shot. Missed it. And rebound by Hixonbaugh. Boy, that was a big miss there.
A lot of contact both ways.
There was a lot of contact both ways and nothing called. Hixonbaugh going to hand the ball off to O'Neill out front.
Hixonbaugh and Zerlini, neither one has scored. Hixonbaugh's got one shot tonight.
Mules have not been able to get those open looks out front. T-Town's kind of taken that away from them as they have extended their defense out there. O'Neill, directing traffic, hands it off to Reese Lee.
Mules look a little out of sync.
They do look a little bit out of sync. Right side, they go to Estes, and timeout's going to be called, and I think that Coach McElravy saw the same thing we saw, realizing that there just was no flow to the offense that time at all. So it's going to be timeout. It'll be Mules ball right in front of their own bench, down six here. This is a big, big possession in the ball game, down by six with 4:59. To go in the contest.
Nicomas on a 13-0 run leads Moeka A&M 54-43, 3:32 left.
Wow. Again, we'll have all these scores posted for you, of course, later on here on our sports website at AreaSports.net. And we invite you to join us for the Sports Couch tomorrow morning as we come your way every Saturday morning during the basketball season on both AreaSports.net and on 90.9 The Vine Radio. As tomorrow morning, we'll be visiting with several coaches. We will have Coach McElravy on with us tomorrow. Win or lose tonight, Coach McElravy will join us, as he has nearly every Saturday morning. And we'll have several other coaches from around the area on the show with us tomorrow morning. We'll take a look at what the final scores are tonight, who the winners and losers are, and we'll get a hold of some of those coaches tonight and have them on the show with us tomorrow morning. So join us for the Sports Couch. We'll talk it over with many area coaches tomorrow on The Vine and on AreaSports.net. That starts at 8:30. 8:30 tomorrow morning. All right, Danny. Fairfield ball.
Mule's got to score about every time now, man.
All possessions are like gold right now, aren't they?
Yep.
Jayzel O'Neal between the circles. There's a screen by Estes. They take away the alley-oop. It's not there. They saw that coming. Now they give the ball back to Gilbert. He'll drive, puts up the shot, scores. They don't have any answer for the penetration of Wyatt Gilbert, though. And there's a another steal. Here's Hickson ball for three. Oh, he missed it. Saved by Reese Lee and tipped by Gilbert. How in the world they saved that, I don't know, but it's into the hands of the Wooden Shoes. They've got it. It's a four-point game with 4:19 left. Here's a drive down the lane, and a basket is good by Mitch Hardick, and the foul's going to be called on the Mules.
O'Neal.
That was close to being a charge. Real close. Real close. Count the bucket. Puts the Shoes back up by six. 45-39 with 4:17 to play in the ballgame. At the line for the and one is Mitch Hardick, and he scores. Shoes back up by seven. 46-39. 4:11 left in the game. Mules in the front court. Wyatt Gilbert has it. Comes out to Reese Lee, almost a steal. Ball's loose on the floor. Hickson ball's got it. Goes down to Dagg. Stolen away by the Shoes. T-Town coming up with the 50-50 balls, Danny.
Yep.
That'll win you games.
Nashville wins 37-22.
Well, Nashville gets the winner of this game Tuesday night at the SIU Arena. Will it be T-Town or Fairfield? Right now the Shoes have the upper hand. Here's a lob down low to Smith. His shot's up and in. That's a big basket.
That may have been the winner right there.
That's a nine-point lead now for T-Town, as on the other end we're going to have a blocking foul called on Smith. Has taken it inside with Jayzel O'Neal. Mules will be in the bonus, so these are big free throws coming up. Stops the clock with 3:29 to go. We'll kind of recap it for you here. Fairfield led after one quarter, 16-6. They led by two at halftime, 22-20. T-Town went on a 19-8 run in the third quarter before Fairfield came back to cut it to 41-35 after three quarters. And now T-Town leads it by nine, 48-39. As O'Neal at the line makes the free throw. Cuts it to eight. Cantrell into the ball game for the Mules. So Dagg is on the floor. Cantrell, Zerlini, as well as O'Neal and Gilbert.
Hickson ball has two shots tonight, Randy, 0 out of 2. And Zerlini has 2, 4, 6, and he's 1 out of 6.
Estes is going to come back into the game, and he is going to replace Jayzel O'Neal with 3:29 to play in the game. 48-41 as the second free throw was made by the Mules. 7-point game. That's a three-possession game. That's big with 3:22 left. The Mules need a stop. They need a turnover. As T-Town's trying to run clock. They're playing catch out there. Playing keep away from the Mules. Right side with it is Hardick. Hardick comes out to the top to Smith. Down low it goes. Pass inside to Weber. And again, the Mules just don't have an answer for Weber. He's been big tonight. How many's he got, Danny? 9-point lead now.
19
points. We said at the top of the broadcast that it was going to be the Smith and Weber show, and that's exactly what it's been for the Wooden Shoes. They get a steal. Up by nine. 2:42 left to play. Not looking good for the Mules. Can they mount a comeback? They need to stop. Here's Wormer taking it inside. There's a steal. Steal by Wyatt Gilbert. It's going to take it all the way down, put it up the shot, and a foul is going to be called on the shoes. That'll send Gilbert to the line. And more importantly, it stops the clock with 2:30 left in the game, giving Fairfield a chance to score with the clock not moving. Down by 9. 50-41 as Jayzel O'Neill gets ready to check back into the ballgame. Mules came in 32-2. T-Town 28-5. T-Town has been ranked one notch higher than Fairfield most of the season, depending upon which poll you look at. T-Town has been one notch ahead of them all year long, even though Fairfield beat them back in November. Wyatt Gilbert at the line, and his free throw is good. That's huge. Checking back in is both Hixonbaugh and O'Neill for Fairfield, replacing Cantrell and Zerlini. So you got Estes, Dagg, Gilbert, O'Neill, and Hixonbaugh on the floor for Fairfield. Again, 2:30 left in the game. Second free throw is good for the Mules. Cuts the lead to 7, 50-43. Now here comes that full pressure defense by the Mules. Can they get a turnover? Can they get a steal? They need it bad. Down 7 points. It's still a 3-possession game as T-Town tries to play keep away, and there's a timeout called as they got to burn one because there was a good trap set up by both Gilbert and O'Neill.
Aaron leads by 2 with 1:34 to go.
Biggest problem with the Mules right now is the time clock, Danny.
Yes, it is.
2 minutes and 20 seconds left, and the Mules find themselves down by 7. They really, really got to get a stop this time. Need a turnover because it's a 3-possession ball game, so they got to have the ball 3 times and convert in order to have a chance here. And we're running out of time. Timeout charge to the Wooden Shoes. Boy, the Fairfield fans have come out in a huge throng tonight. You got to admire this crowd that has come out to support Fairfield tonight and really all season long. It's been a magical run by the Fairfield Mules. School record, 32 wins. Hoping to make it 33 tonight and punch their ticket to the Elite Eight, but it's looking tough right now. Let's see what happens. T-Town will inbound the ball as they get it to Luke Ungren.
A&M wins 63-57. Moeka A&M over Nokomis.
All right, so they'll be going to the SIU Arena in 1A against the winner of Cesar and Woodlawn. Ungren's playing catch out front with Hardick, and that's going to be a hold away from the basketball.
On O'Neill.
Jayzel O'Neill was holding on to Clint Weber as they wanted to get the ball into him. Reese Lee's going to check back in for Luke Dagg with 2:03 left. As at the line will be Clint Weber with 2:03 left in the contest.
Weber's got 19 on the game.
He has definitely been a difference in this game for T-Town. He misses the free throw. It's rebound by Estes. That's a big miss. The Mules need to convert. Wyatt Gilbert takes it down. It's blocked out of bounds by Weber. He took it inside among the tall timber, and it was blocked as Zerlini's going to check back in, and you know that's to try to get a three-point shot if we can. Reese Lee will sit down. Out of bounds on the baseline for Fairfield. Minute 55 left. It's going to be inbounded by O'Neill. O'Neill throws it in out to Hixonbaugh. Hixonbaugh way out front. He's going to drive inside. Stops, pops an 8-footer. Left it short. Just not there. Rebound by T-Town. Shot not falling tonight. They throw it up and to Weber. Again, they're playing keep away with a minute 39 left, and they throw it away.
Hold it to the coach. That's a bad place to throw it.
Turnover on the shoes. Fairfield's got to convert. Missed that opportunity a moment ago.
Mascuda 54, Carbondale 32.
Wow, that's amazing. Beating Carbondale by 22. You know, Mascuda plays a tough schedule, though, over in that Metro East area. Here's Zerlini open for three. Can it go? No, it's short. And it's rebound by Weber. Shots just not falling. Shoes have it. Down to Weber. They're playing keep away out front with Wormer. And that's going to be a foul out front as they foul Dawson Smith. And that's probably not the guy you want to foul.
Four on Gilbert.
Stops the clock with a minute 16 left. And Dawson Smith's going to go back to the line. And he missed some early in the game, but it's been pretty hot lately, hasn't he?
He's 3 out of 3 in the third quarter.
Dawson Smith.
Smith, the 6'6 senior for the Wooden Shoes. And his free throw is good on the first one. 51-43. T-Town by 8. Fairfield fans looking pretty stunned. Rightfully so. We're stunned. 9-point lead for the Shoes. Minute 14 left. Here's a shot way out front. It's off the mark. No good by Gilbert. And ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to belong to Fairfield. Last touch by T-Town. Minute 9 left. Again, still a 3-possession game. 3-point shots just not falling tonight for Fairfield, Danny.
No, Zerlini's hit 1 2-point bucket and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0 out of 6 from behind the arc.
Here's the inbound to Hickson ball. Hickson ball gets it to O'Neal. O'Neal drives baseline, and he's going to be fouled by Smith. So that'll send O'Neal back to the line, and more importantly, it stops the clock with 64 seconds left.
Time's going to run out on the Mules.
Yeah, if you can convert these, it cuts it to 7, but the problem is that's still a 3-possession game, Danny. And Luke Dagg going to check in for Estes. That's probably defense for offense substitution. That foul on Dawson Smith was his second. Free throw is good by Jayzel O'Neal, and he'll get another one. Cuts the lead to 8.
He's got 11 on the night.
What you'd love to see here is a miss and then a tip in by Luke Dagg. Here's a shot, and it's good. 52-45, it's a 7-point game. Down to 63 seconds left, and there's a foul right away on the inbound on Jayzel O'Neal.
It's 4 on O'Neal.
And checking back into the game is going to be Estes. As we're going to walk to the other end and go into the line will be Mitch Hardy. Has he been there tonight?
He's made 1 free throw.
All right.
1 out of 1.
1 out of 1. Hardy, a 6'3 junior.
He's shooting 2.
And he missed that one. Well, whether he makes it or misses it, it's still going to be a 3-possession game here. With 63 seconds left. Landon Zerlini back in the game. You got Estes, Zerlini, Gilbert, Hickson ball, and O'Neal in the game. Second free throw is good. 53-45. Zerlini brings it up for the Mules. Gives it to O'Neal. O'Neal's going to stop, pop a 3-pointer, missed it. 3-point shots just not falling for Fairfield. Rebound by T-Town. Mules trying to chase. And Gilbert's going to be called for the foul, and they unfortunately had to foul Dawson Smith.
That's 5 on him.
And that's going to be, going to be it for Wyatt Gilbert.
Sasser leads 55-36, 1:50 to go.
Fairfield fans come to their feet, give a big, big round of applause to Wyatt Gilbert, who leads here tonight. He's had a heck of a ball game. You know, he did some good penetrating there tonight. Among that tall timber, drew some fouls, made some shots, made some free throws. As a free throw is missed here by Dawson Smith. 47 seconds left in the Fairfield Mule season. Down by 8.
Gilbert leaves with 15.
Smith's second free throw. Missed that. Rebound Estes. Can the Mules get a quick one here? Here's a drive all the way down, and a foul's going to be called on the Shoes. Is taking it down quickly was Jayzel O'Neal, and he'll go to the line to shoot a pair of free throws, stopping the clock with 42 seconds left.
Foul's going to be on Weber. That's his first foul.
Well, if he can make both of these, that would get it down to a two-possession game. Still give Fairfield some time. But he misses the free throw. That's tough. He'll have another one. Luke Dagg back in the game. You got Estes, Hickson Ball, Reese Lee, Dagg, and at the free throw line, O'Neal with his second one. And that one rattles in and out, no good. Rebound Wormert for T-Town, and a foul's going to be called on the Mules.
Hickson Ball, that'll be four on him.
Boy, the shots have just not been falling for the Mules. A walk to the other end with 40 seconds to go. T-Town at the line in the person of Evan Wormer.
One out of eight this quarter.
Woodlawn's down by 20 with a minute 50 to go. Free throw is missed by Wormer. Another one coming, 40 seconds to play. That one he got. 54-45, it's a 9-point lead. Reese Lee brings it in the front court, gives it to Landon Zerlini. He'll put up the shot. It was partially blocked and out of bounds. It's going to be Fairfield ball. Evan Wormert was on him. He's 6'2". Zerlini at 6'3". Mule fans wanted a foul. There was no foul called. It's Fairfield ball out of bounds with 32 seconds left underneath the basket. As they throw it in, it's stolen away by Weber. Look out, Weber's going to go in for the jam. And Estes says, no, you're not. And Estes fouls him. He definitely had jam time on his mind.
Sesser wins 55-39, so they'll be playing Central A&M. 63-57 winners over.
They actually gave the foul to Reese Lee down low. Could have given it to Estes, but they gave it to Reese Lee. Stops the clock with 27 seconds left. So Sesser will be playing Mawiqua Central A&M?
Yes.
Down at SIU Arena in the 1A Super Sectional Tuesday night. Nashville looks like they're going to play T-Town in the 2A Super Sectional as the Shoes lead it by 9 here with 27 seconds left. Another free throw coming by Weber. He missed the first one, but he got the second one. 55-45, T-Town by 10, 25 seconds left. Mules in the front court. Reese Lee missed a shot on the baseline. Mules just can't buy a bucket. And Dawson Smith trying to dribble it out for T-Town. 14 seconds left. Fairfield chasing. T-Town fans on their feet. Wooden Shoes are gonna win it. As Landon Zerlini takes it down and lays it in. That's the ball game. Teutopolis has defeated the Fairfield Mules and ends their season at 32-3. A heartbreaking loss tonight for the Fairfield Mules. Second time these two teams have played each other. Teutopolis wins the game when it counts here in postseason after Fairfield beat them back in November. Both teams been state ranked in the top 10 all year long. It's one of those things where, you know, you hate to see a team lose, but that's what March Madness is all about. Only one can survive and one moves on. And tonight, it is the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes. 55-47 is the final, as Danny is working on our post-game stats. And we will share those with you here in just a moment. Want to remind you tonight's broadcast has been made possible by Frontier Community College, where summer and fall registration begins March 26th. Frontier is rated as the 15th best two-year trade school in America by Forbes magazine. That's Frontier Community College in Fairfield. So the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes will advance on in the Class 2A playoffs. They will take on the Nashville Hornets on Tuesday night down at the SIU Arena. Nashville spanked T-Town just a couple of weeks ago down at Benton at the shootout. In fact, they blew the Shoes away in that game as Nashville's been ranked number one all year long. We'll see what happens in the rematch down there Tuesday night at the SIU Arena. Again, Danny is totaling up our stats. I want to take this moment to thank everybody along the way that has logged on and enjoyed our broadcast this year. We thank all the Fairfield Mule fans who have gotten behind this team. It's been a storybook season, to say the least. You know, when you go 32-3, I mean, that's a once-in-a-lifetime happening. Never in the history of Fairfield Community High School has a team won 32 basketball games. And along the way, they won the Thanksgiving tournament at Lawrence County. They won the El Dorado Holiday Tournament at Christmas time. They won the Carmi Invitational Tournament. They won the regional tournament down at Harrisburg. They won their semifinal game against Pena here on Tuesday night. But they just have a rough second half tonight, and they fall short to the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes. And you got to give the Shoes credit here as they win it by 8 points, 55-47. To kind of recap it scoring-wise for you by quarters, Fairfield jumped out to a 16-6 lead. And at one point of the second quarter, they also led by 10. But T-Town came roaring back and cut it to a two-point game at halftime. Fairfield led by two at half, 22-20. Then T-Town went on a 19-8 run early in the third quarter. That really turned the game around. Fortunately, the Mules were able to cut into that a little bit and get it back to a six-point game after three quarters, 41-35. But in the fourth quarter, the ball just would not go in the basket for Fairfield, Danny. And T-Town wins it here by 8 points, 55-47. Your thoughts and also the stats.
Well, the second half, Randy, the Mules were 7 out of 20 on field goals.
Wow.
They finished 17 out of 40 for 42%. Shoot 10 out of 12 from the free throw line for 83%. Had 14 turnovers on the night. Scoring, Reese Lee had none. Wyatt Gilbert had 15. Giselle O'Neill had 12. Hicksonball didn't score. Estes had 8. Zerlini had 2. Dagg had 6. And Cantrell had 2. So when you look at that, Zerlini only with 2 and Hicksonball not scoring, that tells a lot about the outcome here tonight.
Mm-hmm.
For T-Town, they were 20 out of 35 for 58% on field goals, but they were only 13 out of 24 on free throws for 54%. They shoot better from the free throw or field goals than they do on free throws. Scoring, Smith has 20. Ungard has 3. Wormert has 6. Hardick has 4. Weber has 20, and Dries has 2, so the big two get 40 of their 55 here tonight. They had 14 turnovers also, had 9 in the first quarter, Randy.
Yeah, you're right. In that first quarter, I mean, Fairfield's defense was just going to town on the Wooden Shoes, and they just couldn't find themselves. But, boy, they kind of regrouped there midway through the second quarter and cut that lead to 2 by halftime. And I thought the real adjustment that Teutopolis made was the fact that they stopped trying to just pass and dribble into the trap, and they got past that by throwing the ball long up and down the sidelines, and they were able to break the pressure defense that the Mules put on and get it into the front court so that they could get into their offense. And then once they got into their offense, the offense, as we thought, you know, they ran it through the big guy, Clint Weber, and between him and Dawson Smith, I mean, that they were that 1-2 punch tonight for the Wooden Shoes.
Mules shoot 35% in the second half.
Yeah, big difference as T-Town clamped down defensively in the second half and win this game by 8 points, 55-47. What will the Wooden Shoes try to do against Nashville on Tuesday night? I don't know. That Nashville team, if you've not seen them play, they are the real deal. They're ranked number one for...
Alton tried to slow them down tonight. Nashville said, that's fine. We'll just lower our defensive total some more here.
Yeah. And what was the final on that one again?
Let me look here.
I put you on the spot, didn't I?
Let me look real quick. I've had a lot of scores sent. 37-22.
Yeah. Yeah, low-scoring game, but nonetheless, Nashville makes the adjustment, and they win it. So congratulations to Wayne Hari. We may have Wayne on the show with us tomorrow morning. We'll have the sports couch at 8:30. We'll talk to Coach Scott McElravy. I'm sure it'll be a tough discussion, but he's joined us all year long, win or lose, and we'll have him tomorrow morning.
You know, Randy, I want to thank everybody. It's been a great season. This will be our last broadcast of the season.
Yep.
You know, we've had a lot of great support. Thank all our sponsors. Thank all the coaches for the time they've given us and dictated to us this season. Heron wins 60-58 here tonight.
Wow. They beat Belleville Altoff.
There's a team that's on a roll.
They are
on
a roll.
That's 20 in a row since the El Dorado Holiday Tournament.
And Fairfield was the last team to beat them. Yeah.
You know, so anyway.
It's been a fun season. We've seen a lot of great basketball, a lot of great teams, individual efforts. And this storybook run by the Fairfield Mules, a school record, 32 wins. Wow, what can you say? Trip to the Sweet 16 and almost made it to the Elite Eight. Been a lot of fun for Fairfield fans. And the cupboard won't be bare next year. Fairfield will have a lot of guys coming back. Graduation-wise, of course, they're going to lose Jayzel O'Neill, Reese Lee, Cody Cantrell, Brian Estes, Logan Trent. But they'll have a lot of guys back. And that JV team was very, very good for Fairfield this year, too. And so they'll be able to build upon that. And I'm sure they'll be hungry when they come back next year, too.
Well, you know, all good things must come to an end in another season for me and you.
Yeah. And it's a bitter pill for them to swallow. But you know what? When they wake up tomorrow morning and reflect back on the season and what they've accomplished this year, you got to be proud with what they've done. So, well, again, we thank everybody for being along on the broadcast. Hope you enjoyed it. Not the outcome that Fairfield fans wanted, certainly. But congratulations to the Teutopolis Wooden Shoes as they move on to the Elite Eight. So for Danny Ounceman, I'm Randy Olson saying thanks again. And the final score from Vandalia, Teutopolis 55 and Fairfield 47. So long.